So many comments you made on our last two programs, the program we had with the other movie man.
Edu Boma.
And the doyen of the Nigerian film industry. And of course, the program we had with Charlie Boy Friday night.
Yes.
In case a lot of people have been calling to say, can we repeat those programs? We may repeat them in future, but for now you can go on our online portal, hblnews.com, so you can watch those programs, or you download our application on the Google Store or on the iPhone Store. Well, like Mamode said, a lot is happening.
Yes, Obiora, so much is happening, and you know, the real, the major news headline in Nigeria now is the National Assembly. It's APC, it's what they are going to do about Bukola Saraki and Dogara, two people who, in spite of the party's decision, went ahead to become principal officers, president of the Senate and speaker of the House of Representatives.
And
well, right after that, Obiora, we've gotten to a point where they needed to appoint other principal officers in those two chambers, and that again is sparking serious row between APC and these leaders.
Well, I don't know, except you just came in from mass this morning. I'm sure you, like many other Nigerians and people around the world, saw the first class boxing match and karate and kung fu and judo.
I want to practice the art of ring announcing.
Yes, because if you have any plans to be in the National Assembly someday,
yes,
you need to get any of those.
No, I don't want to be in there. I want to be around there as a ring announcer. You know, I
mean, just announce what is happening.
I'm a broadcaster.
Who is kicking?
Yes,
whose shirt is being torn? Who is doing work?
You know,
this is another one they specialize in now. Worker.
Weighing 140 pounds in the umbrella corner.
Yes.
And weighing 250 pounds in the broom corner.
Yes.
You know, and then the bell goes back down, and the next thing, punches are flying in the air, you know.
And then sometimes there are some the good guys, the bouncers, that shield the main man, like the speaker.
Yes.
You know. We have all sorts in the National Assembly.
Yeah, you know. Funny enough, when those punches start flying, you know, there's always some kind of, protection around the speaker.
By members of the National Assembly.
Yeah, by members of the National Assembly, members of his own caucus, you know, but the mace, did you see how they were struggling to, you know, to take a hold of that mace?
Well.
You know, but that gentleman, honorable members, you don't really need to fight over that mace, really. We saw so many years ago, a new mace can be made.
They should have just allowed the guy go with the mace, and then someone brings another one.
And the meeting continues. You know, even when Chuba Akadibo took the mace to his shrine
in the village,
for safekeeping.
But come on, Mamode. You know, in all that drama of that day, I pitied the guy, the representative whose shirt
was
torn and his clothes was almost naked. How did he go home to his wife
kids? Yes.
Or they got him a change of clothes on the way home?
I think one of the attributes for one of the attributes for becoming a legislator is that you must have decreased immunity towards shame. Shame is something you also have to learn to accommodate.
Yes, it becomes part of you.
Yeah, it becomes part
of you. It has
to
get into your DNA.
Yeah, this is not the first time we are seeing torn clothes. I mean, you remember the Dino Melaye days with, you know, a practically torn singlet shirt all over, you know, and then, I mean, it's just horrible. But it's not only in Nigeria. That's why I said to become a legislator, I mean, it's worldwide, really. We've seen chairs flying in the parliament in Japan. We've seen punches thrown across parliament in Europe and all that. So Nigerians are not different.
But Mamode, is it not time members of the National Assembly got together and decided how to move on? You know, one of the members made available to me the draft legislative agenda. of the eighth house.
Yes.
And it talked about legislating for to improve power, better unemployment
Obiora, look.
I shouldn't bother you with all the details.
Please. We're going to, maybe you should, you know, bring that legislative agenda so we can have a program on it. We've seen all that in the past. We've seen contract with Nigeria. We're seeing legislative agenda now. Nigerians, I mean, I'm going to talk to Nigerians now. Seriously speaking, do you think that those guys were throwing punches at each other so they could give you light in your house? Do you think that they were tearing each other's clothes so that they could tar the road in your streets? Come on. All this is about personal, selfish aggrandizement.
And you know, that takes me to what's making headlines in almost all the papers, the interview. Or the I don't know where he made the speech or whatever.
Yes.
Saraki made. I dropped my presidential ambition for Buhari. Oh, there was no deal with the PDP.
The Buhari people are saying.
And I mean, how can Saraki be telling us all this? He said he didn't know about any plan when there were a series of meetings he participated in. He even confided in this same interview that he was awake having meetings till 4 a.m. and he's saying he didn't know about the PDP. You know, sometimes I want to believe what some members of APC are saying, that all their troubles, all the wahala, all the pains, all the struggle, that Saraki gave it away over a pot of porridge, like we read in the Bible.
Yes.
And he's coming to tell Nigerians he didn't know he was in his car, they were going to kidnap him. These guys think we didn't go to school or something.
That is part of politics. I mean, you should expect that. He wouldn't be a good politician if he was not able to...
If he told us that brought him there, the truth?
No. Truth is not always the answer in politics.
He said he was not aware or invited to APC meeting with Buhari. So in other words, he never heard of it. Even when they rushed the National Assembly, he didn't know that his colleagues were...
If he was
a good party man and he meant well, wouldn't he have started looking for his colleagues?
He was in the car park at early as 6 in the morning because some people said he was likely going to be abducted, because if he was not on the floor of the Senate, then you could not nominate him. So he hid in a car, in a very small car.
Not the kind of car that
you would expect somebody of his status to be in, mm-hmm. so that people just overlook. He hid in a small car from 6 a.m. till about 10 in the morning. And, you know, just went in there. So, you know...
Didn't even know that they were going to elect him.
To be a politician, you have to know so many things. You know, it's becoming clear to me now. And one of those things, you really have to know how to, you know, maneuver.
Mamode, the unfortunate thing is that it's moving from the National Assembly to the heart of the APC. There's going to be... A meeting of the Board of Trustees, I think, on Tuesday.
Well, if you ask me, I say about time.
Yes.
About time.
But
that's
the problem is that this fight has already started before the meeting.
But there's now
a fight whether Tinubu will be chairman of the Board of Trustees.
Or whether Atiku
will be chairman of Board of Trustees. They are going to bring Ogbe to start a disciplinary committee.
There's nothing wrong with that. If you ask me, really, what we are seeing in APC is natural. This is a marriage of convenience, of strange bedfellows. They didn't really take the time to know each other before. They had one common agenda: gentlemen, let's unite and kick Jonathan out.
That was the binding
Are
you
factor.
Saying that the change Jonathan, mantra, the change mantra was just
all that was you know all that was just to kick Jonathan out. Now the common enemy is gone, and they are fighting amongst themselves. Who is superior? Is it the new PDP with that Saraki and Co belongs to? Is it the ACN that Gbajabi and Mila and the Tinubus belong to? Or is it AMPP that Ogbonaya Odu and Co belong to? Or is it CPC, the Buhari faction? So these different factions in APC are all getting together now to establish supremacy and leadership of the APC, and that's what we are seeing. Hopefully, they will be able able to to take care of it, we don't know. But that's what's in the papers.
It's everywhere, so there's no way we can talk about anything.
And that's everything, apart from the Oshomole who says his salary is less than 700,000.
And someone asked, was that the 700,000 he used to build the mansion in his village? Yeah, well, I mean, because the 700,000, someone said that, I didn't say so, I heard. But I know that if you build a mansion in the village, you can't do it to 700,000 times 6 or 7 years, you know. So,
I won't be drawn.
Let these politicians
I won't be drawn into that.
Let them just go ahead and do what they're doing.
All right, to tell
pretend
you,
that we don't know about it.
To tell you what, we're going to stay with the National Assembly because it's very, very important to us. So we're going to be discussing that later on when we come back with our guests. We have somebody from PDP and we also have somebody from the APC, and we're going to be discussing that. We have joining us Honorable EJ Agbonima, who is a representative PDP from Edo State and a very, very good friend to the O&M show.
We also have Honorable Abdulrahman Shuaibu, also a member of the House of Representatives, representing Mubi North South in Adamawa State. Well, they
this
are
is of the APC.
Yeah, and they're here. So if some of the things we said were not too very true, well, maybe they will clear it or just ignore it. Like, you know, a couple of people we spoke to, they said, don't talk to me about the crisis.
All right.
So we'll do all that when we
just
return.
Stay with us. We'll be right back after this timeout. Don't go away.
Yaba, yaba, yaba. Yaba, 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 yaba. Where my money? Oh, me that. Waiting. Now every time when I come this place, you go collect money. I never pay you for this money. Now money be that, now. Nah. Hey, it is on afternoon. You never pay afternoon money, now. Nah.
My friend, don't give him any money, dear. Don't give him 10 kobo. Nonsense.
I go call my oga phone now. I go call crusher. Call him, now. Nah. Yaba, yaba, yaba.
Order me, Russia. Them no one pay money, oh.
Yaba, yaba, yaba. Yaba, 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 yaba.
See, I'm there.
Now you no one pay my money, Abby.
Now what thing be this?
I will crush you.
Come on, get away from here.
Conductor, no agree.
You know me. Do you
that's
anything?
What they do. Useless
people. Yeah, we dey here. Now we dey here. Now we get out.
I will crush you.
Come out here.
Peter. Peter. I go.
Conductor. Peter. Get him.
I go crush you.
See this one. No. No.
Yeah. Oh, magic.
Yes, now getting down to brass tacks, joining us first all the way from Edo State, where he represents Ego Ipoboka Federal Constituency, is Honorable EJ Agbonima. He's a friend of the O&M show, he's a gentleman with whom I have had a show like this way back in the United States of America.
Thank you very much for having me again.
Yes,
how are you, my brother?
I'm good. You're welcome.
We're just saying that we were co-anchors on a show back in the US, but now I get to interview you. You are a big politician now. So
we also have Honorable Abdulrahman Shuaibu. Honorable Shuaibu, we are glad to have you too. We may not have had a program in the United States, but I'm glad you're here.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
But I want to, I want to start with all the fights. I thought that there'll be a marked difference today, but it looks like everyone has joined the Buhari attire, you know, both PDP and APC. And each time the House members are coming here, they're all wearing white.
Maybe it looks like
For me, I'm just coming from the church and want to serve God.
So I was surprised to see him wearing the same. Almost, it was not planned, and you know, well,
because fine. I'm just also wondering that if I were you, from what we see in the house now, I won't wear Babari get to the place, because once someone just pulls you and you're down, it's not fight ready, you know.
But are you guys?
Well, for me, most of the time I'm in white, so most of my clothes are white.
Okay.
But are you guys visiting the gym now? Doing some exercises.
Because you never know who's going to hit.
You never know when.
No.
You may need to throw some punches.
Well, you can ask the APC. So.
It's an APC thing.
Yes, an APC thing.
The fight.
So, PDP is not a trial, so
but you guys are the National Assembly.
No, PDP was only protecting PDP was only protecting the speaker.
Oh, they were protecting.
They were protecting the speaker. And they were trying to remove the mess.
No, because
not only protecting
the speaker, we wanted peace for the nation. And you wouldn't want to see. Look, let's call a spade, you know. Going back, looking at my children calling me to tell me, oh, daddy, can you imagine you're fighting on the National Assembly? These are your own children telling you this, and it was very disheartening. And I have to encourage and tell them, no, it was just something that happened, because it is not expected from us. Let's call a spade. I think it's unaccepted to Nigerians.
No, I think that maybe we should get something straight. Mm-hmm. This fighting, as I was saying when myself and Obiora were doing the intro, so I was saying earlier on, it's worldwide. You see this fighting in other parliaments across the world.
But it's wrong.
So, no, it's not wrong. It's not wrong.
It's wrong.
No, let me get down.
Maybe he's talking about the message.
Yes, the difference in it. When you see them fighting abroad, in parliament abroad, it is about ensuring that a particular project, you cannot close down the shipbuilding company in my constituency.
Okay, all right.
You cannot do that. You are going to take away 5,000 jobs. And so the other man says, no, they are bringing a naval academy. For that academy to get to his own constituency, they have to close the shipbuilding one in this constituency. So the loss of 5,000 jobs here is a gain of 5,000 jobs on this side. And so
there's
fighting.
A disagreement.
There's a disagreement, and
disagreement
they can get physical.
To the point of having physical
yes,
fight?
No. Yes.
Well, I don't agree with Mamode that this
no,
right.
I don't think that is
but
right.
I think
no,
what
no, no.
Mamode is saying is that
I'm
the reason
that,
for the fight yes. usually is something that has to do with the people.
That's dialogue. Consultation.
No. I'm not saying that 3 points is okay. Yes.
Is the reason for the fight. Okay, you are from the National Assembly. Tell us what the fight was about. What was the fight about? Yes.
To be honest to you, I think I will defer to the APC brother.
Don't chicken out.
No, you were there.
PDP is not on trial here. Mm-hmm. So I think this is APC versus APC in the House.
No, even APC is not on trial. It's the National Assembly.
It's National Assembly, but they are the one that have brought this to National Assembly.
No. EJ, this is not your first time on the show. Like we said, you are a friend to this show. You've always made it very clear
yes.
that once you get into the Green Chamber, all this party thing is put at the background.
That is the reason why when you saw PDP protecting the speaker, we wanted to prove to the world this is not about PDP or APC. We are one family, regardless of your political affiliation. We are representing our various constituency. So the issue that is the bone of contention today, I think, honestly, it was orchestrated by the APC.
Okay, Honorable Shuaibu, he has put it on your table.
Okay, let's hear you.
Thank you very much. You see, the issue with what happened in the National Assembly is not something, it's about, everything is about what is happening in Nigeria. It has not started that day. It started long time ago. Yeah. You know, if you know how APC came into being, it was a combination of different political parties. It was AMPP, ACN, and CPC.
And new PDP.
First of all, these were the three plus a faction of ABGA.
Yes.
This came into being to form a political party called APC. Then later, the new APC, very powerful force, new PDP.
Very powerful,
very
force.
Powerful
you
force.
To
very powerful force. With five governors.
Yes.
about more than 20 senators.
Some of the
more than 70, more than 70 members of the House of Reps, which later included the Speaker, came and joined APC. So we came together, went to campaign, and won the election. First of all, what APC should have done was to immediately zone
the offices. Your leaders didn't listen to us.
Which APC failed to do. So let us be honest so that we can solve these problems once and for all. Which APC failed to do. Then the second thing, in the whole calculation, you know, when we went for the party primaries in Lagos for the election of the president, those three political parties, even in our states, the ACN, AMPP, and CP, they were meeting separately from the new PDP. So
but they were.
They were. So they came together and we had two contestants from the new PDP, the former Vice President Atiku Abubakar and the former governor of now Senator Kano, Rabiu Musa Kwankoso. They were from the new PDP. They all contested for the presidency, but Buhari won. Yes. With the voice of many of them were coming from those three amalgamated groups. So after that, Buhari is from CPC. Yes. When they were getting the vice president, they brought him from the ACN.
ACN, yes.
So the election were held. APC won the election with the support of everybody, including the new PDP. Very powerful force, as I said. Saraki and others who are also in the new
PDP.
If you follow what APC wanted to do in the National Assembly, Senate President Ahmed Lawan from AMPP, Deputy Senate President Akume from ACN, House of Reps Speaker Femi Bajami Amila, ACN, Deputy Mohamed Mongono, AMPP.
So nothing for the new PDP.
There was the calculation did not take care
of new PDP.
Of new PDP completely.
Okay.
And the new PDP had a lot of senators, like Danjuma.
You even led the presidential campaign.
So they even led the presidential campaign. So they should have taken care of this group in that calculation. It was not taken care of. So it's a serious problem.
So that they took care of themselves.
And you know, PDP also were trying to push.
Yes, to take advantage.
To take advantage and instigate.
Was there anything wrong?
They are lost brothers.
They are lost brothers.
Politics.
So that they can benefit from it, which they did at the Senate. Yes. They actually did by getting the deputy Senate president.
Because they had 49
and then they had 49. They needed just few. Yes. And in fact, even in the House of Representatives, we have more than 80 members, definitely from the new PDP. Dogara needed just 42 out of these over 80 members to join with the PDP for him to emerge as speaker. So the calculation was not properly taken care of. I think that is the genesis of this
crisis.
I think it's
a fight for supremacy. Can we safely say that the new PDP has emerged as the strongest force within the APC?
It has always been very strong when it came in.
No, I mean strongest.
Tell me, out of all the other political parties, apart from the ACN, none of the political parties that has come with up to five governors, with that number of senators, that number of House of Reps, including the Speaker.
You cannot underrate
that
PDP
with the former vice president. So it's a very powerful force.
So let's get this clear.
Yes.
I mean, let's understand ourselves. So the issue, like Mamodi said, is not the people. It is the interest of those that came together to form the APC. Everybody wants to get something in it, and then when they have done that, then they can now talk about the people.
No, but how do you serve the people if you don't get something? If you don't have if you have to position yourself very well to be able to serve the people.
You know.
So if you are not properly positioned, you will not be able to serve the people. So maybe at the end of the day, if that calculation has gone through, that means those that have come from the states with new PDP may have lost out completely.
And nothing to tell their constituencies.
So you have to position yourself properly for you to be able to serve the people.
In addition,
okay,
let me say that, you know,
this is feeling very important today. I'm very happy. The situation of PDP excites you so much.
Of course, I'm a proud PDP member. So, and we are waxing stronger and stronger by the day. That's what is expected. And those who thought that PDP, oh, you are nowhere, but they can see that we are back stronger as ever. Let me just say this, that, you know, what happened at the National Assembly, it is an unfortunate situation. You know, where you see, you know, APC fighting themselves, for what reason? Yes, like I've said often in the other media, you know, briefing, APC should have been able to handle their problem at their secretariat. But if they have somebody that they wanted to be the leader, the majority leader of the House, is their majority. Let them decide and harmonize and do that at the APC secretariat, not at the floor of the National Assembly. Because that is the Nigerian House.
The letter they brought
that they addressed to the speaker to announce the leadership of APC at the floor that was what brought this issue of infighting at the House
of Commons. But in other words,
the party had a position. The party had their candidates. Because you were saying they should solve this problem at the secretariat.
If they have their candidates, if they have to resolve their problem at their secretariat, it's only coming to announce it to the members. But that didn't, I don't think that happened.
No, the letter was leaked. It wasn't supposed to be.
No, you see, the major thing is that a letter was written from the APC. Even if the speaker was not interested in the letter, he should have announced, I've received a letter from APC and let us not talk about this letter at the in the floor of the House. Let us, APC caucus should meet so time, so venue, so that we can resolve this issue. That should have solved that problem. Then number two, what actually started that problem at on that day was somebody raised, immediately he came, he announced that we were dissolving into an executive session. Somebody raised a point of order. He refused to listen to him. He went ahead and concluded the.
I'm not holding brief for the speaker.
So he should.
Let me finish.
So he should have listened to that person who has raised the point of order and rule him out of order if he wanted.
Yes.
So he should have ruled him out of order, then see what will happen. But he refused to listen to him. So I think we should learn to respect people. We should learn to respect also
standing rules.
Yes. We should also learn to respect other views that are not in line with our own views. So that's what we should learn.
This happened.
If not, the fight will continue to be, because another time, himself will raise a point of order and the speaker may refuse to recognize him.
Honorable Shaibu, let's get this thing clear. You were here just now, we were talking about somebody who got, you know, his clothes were tore. You said you didn't even see that person. But I'm telling you, it happened at the floor. Mm-hmm. Maybe you were not paying attention. But I want to tell you that the speaker was not even given the opportunity. Everything happened just like this. So for you to say
somebody
that...
Somebody raised a point of order.
Hold on. Mm-hmm. Somebody raised a point of order. How many people raised a point of order that day? It's not even one person. More than 5-6 people raised a point of order. He was looking to try to identify who to... Before you know it, the whole everything went there bizarre.
No.
So he was not given an opportunity either to make that pronouncement, to even give an opportunity for that person to speak. Somebody that raised.
No, he left his seat.
Gentlemen, I want to ask you a question. Is it legal? Is it acceptable in the House? You are members. When you look at your order and all that, is it acceptable for the APC to come out with the list of officers and send it to the House for implementation? Is it proper?
It wasn't sent. I don't think it was sent to the House.
It was sent to the Speaker.
It was sent to the Speaker.
It's supposed to be announced.
It can be announced on the rule of the House. Will it be binding
on the House if it had been announced?
Yes.
Yeah, of course. It's the party.
It's the party.
It's the majority. Majority always take the other. At least that is APC. Just like
PDP will bring the same thing.
PDP will do the same thing.
So why did the speaker not do what he was supposed to do, since the party had said these are our principal officers? So I'm asking.
At least you were, you being ART, you were there that day.
Yeah.
You watched every event that took place there. At least as a human being, let's call a spade a spade. We begin to point this game, you know, blaming each other, blame game. I said, Mr. Speaker was not even given an ample opportunity to even make any statement of such. This thing happened. Look, it was just like this.
So fast.
So fast. The next thing you see people
fighting. But it gets
this pointing about the speaker didn't do this. Let me tell you this. He's the speaker of the house. He must be respected. Do whether you voted for him or not, he was duly elected. But respect the office. The issue now is, does that mean that we have to take the law into our hands? Does that mean that you have to not start fighting each other?
But EJ.
No, but eventually the speaker came out with his list. Yes. They wanted to stop him from coming out with his list.
No, there's a point we need to establish here very clearly. Because EJ keeps going back to the fact that nobody allowed the speaker to, you know, even make a ruling on the matter. The speaker of the House of Representatives is the speaker.
Yes.
And he has the right at whatever time when he sees that things may, you know, maybe break down of law and order,
when
to call the sergeant
chaotic.
At arms. To call the sergeant at arms. He had the right and the privilege to do that.
Did you see how people rushed to go and grab the maze? At what time?
But who are the people that rushed? It was the PDP life. People that rushed.
See, people, they said they wanted to see the way he was protected.
Okay,
he probably would have been nicked.
He's saying that the PDP rushed for the mess.
It was PDP that rushed there.
Don't drag me. It was APC, those in support of the speaker. But at the same time, a lot of the PDP members wanted to make sure that there was peace in the house.
No, that's
what we will stand for.
Are you law enforcement agents, the APC members? Are they law enforcement agents? When you say they want to ensure,
huh? To where two people are fighting, where two people are fighting, what do you do?
Hold on.
No, where two people are fighting, what do you do?
Nobody was
prepared. Do you join her to ask them to keep on fighting?
It depends on the situation. If they are
so
very
if
big
PDP
people,
saw that APC versus APC is fighting, we wanted to make sure that the house was in the order, peaceful. That is not what we
We saw the PDP singing and shouting and encouraging them.
Nobody fighting the speaker.
We came to represent
the people of this country. It was not the speaker.
Gentlemen,
that
I think there's an important question we need to ask.
Go ahead.
And I'll just ask Honorable Schreiber.
Yes.
When you went to the chambers of the House of Representatives that morning, that fateful morning, did you not have any inkling that it's going to be a rowdy day? Did something not tell you in your mind that we are going for some kind of contest, some kind of today,
no,
anything
you see,
happen.
We knew there was a letter from APC. We knew.
Yes, I'm not talking about that.
The thing
but
is, nobody will have thought that they will have been that rowdy.
As chaotic as it was.
As chaotic as it was.
You had no idea.
What brought
you're
that?
Asking, do you whether you knew?
No, I didn't know. What brought the chaos was when immediately the speaker, immediately after the prayers, he said we should dissolve into an executive. What are people thought? Oh, he wanted to avoid that letter written by APC.
Can you imagine?
You understand that?
That's
and somebody raised a point of order. He refused to listen to him. He should have listened and ruled him out of order if he wanted. But he refused.
I ask you the same question. Did you not have any feeling that day that as we're going through this session now, today is going to be a very, very rowdy day because we have some contentious issues to look at?
To be honest to you, I was not privileged to all this at all. I was only looking at some of the motion that some of my friend wanted to, pass, that will help the people of this country. That was of my interest that we were deliberating on. They came to talk to me, please support me in this motion. And I saw it, I went through it. I said, this is good for our country. This is why we were sent here, to represent the good people of this country. But unfortunately, all this he came to bear. What do you do? Only to watch two people fighting. And we will try to do whatever we can to make sure that everything was brought to normality.
Okay, gentlemen.
But however,
let me tell you what happened again.
No, gentlemen, we've spent so much time talking about what happened and what did not happen.
Yes.
Can we move forward? We have seen the situation. Everybody in Nigeria today is worried about the future of our National Assembly.
Thank you.
Everybody in Nigeria is worried about the future of the APC. Gentlemen, how do
not
you
the
think
future of the APC, the people, the future of our country.
No, that's also
a consideration. To bring electricity, that is what should be our bond of contention.
That's a consideration. But the APC is our ruling party. And if they continue to have this kind of turmoil,
we won't go anywhere.
So you gentlemen are privileged among, I remember what the speaker said on that. He said, look, among the about 170 million Nigerians, about 300 and something of us, we are chosen to represent our people. So you are a very privileged group. How do we move forward? Ija, I'll start with you, because the PDP is very important in the calculation.
Thank
for
you very much.
The way
I
forward.
Think this is a very, it's a wonderful, you know, question and need a very serious answer. For me, I see this country that is going to require Nigerians to build this country. We were sent to represent our constituency, effectively, to bring dividends of democracy to the doorstep of the people. Look, go to Dubai. 10, 15 years ago, Dubai was just a desert. People built Dubai. But unfortunately, we begin to play politics of shenanigans, forgetting, talking about issues. We are not playing politics of selfish interest, not selflessness. So until you begin to put Nigerians first and thinking about your people, if you were sent here to represent your people, it is a privilege. It is not a right. People voted for you, yes. It is a report card. If you do well, yes, you can return back. But unfortunately, we are not playing this as if, oh, this APC, this PDP. We are one Nigeria. Look, my dear brothers and sisters, and our viewers, Nigerians belong to all of us. This blame game, I am not interested. His APC, I am PDP, has nothing to do with me. We relate very well in the house. I don't see him as a Muslim or myself as a Christian. I see him as a Nigerian, as a brother, as a friend.
Ije, how do we move forward?
The way to
move forward in this problem.
In this is for us to come back and say, let's think about this country, how to build the nation. How can we do that? It's the dialogue. You can disagree to, you know, agree and agree to disagree. But the point I'm trying to say is not about fighting. It's not going to physical.
Okay.
What we need to do, what is important? We must do whatever it takes to come back to the house, resolve our differences. Let's come like the agenda that the speaker brought. Very, very much interesting. And like I was watching you saying just now that, oh, others have done the same. No. This eighth session, yes, the issue that took place, it will come. And I think we're going to put that behind us. We must move forward to build a better Nigeria. If we come together collectively, regardless of your political affiliation, by putting Nigeria first, we will excel. Not making noise, making it possible that reality come to bear.
Honorable Shuaibu.
Yes.
The APC and its presidential flag bearer, now President Muhammadu Buhari, told Nigerians that he will not interfere in the election of principal officers of the National Assembly. Some of us warned at that time that it was a dangerous move when they kept shifting and postponing the meeting to decide on the principal officers. We warned on this program that they needed to take a definite position. They didn't listen to us. Now there's crisis. Finally, it looks like the president is about to get involved because he has described the emergence of Saraki as a setback. The emergence of the PDP candidate, Deputy Senate President Kweremadu, as a setback for his administration. So he's now talking about, it looks like he wants to get involved.
Do you was think, he setback when Tabuwa was the speaker?
Do you think that that Jonathan? Can solve this problem? Do you think that can restore peace?
Yes, definitely. Initially, he said he was not going to be involved, and even the APC, thinking that people will do what is right. People will have that party discipline and follow at least what is right. If it was just PDP, APC members that were contesting, at least that problem is not as much in the House of Reps as it is in the Senate. If it was just APC members that were doing it, no, the president and the party wouldn't have been so much concerned about it. But it came to a point that there was no party discipline. People were aligning with opposition political parties. The PDP promised transformation. APC promised change. Most of us were voted because we promised change. That change. So how do you get that change if you don't get the right people to lead in the various arms of government? You cannot get that change. So you have to be, that's why now that he has discovered that people were not following the party discipline, people are not disciplined, they have to restore discipline in the party, so he has to be involved now. But initially, if people are disciplined, because most of us are voted, and there is what we call in the north, SAC, APC SAC.
What does that mean? The
vote APC from down to up.
Okay.
From House of Assembly to president. President. So many of us came under that APC SAC. Not because of our individual distinct, because Buhari promised change. And people know that Buhari has that integrity. He has the knowledge and the capacity to bring that change. So they thought it's better we vote APC members so that they will also go and support him. But when you begin to go against what Buhari and the party is thinking about, definitely he has to be involved. He can call the party, the leaders in the National Assembly, and even all the APC representatives and the senators, we discuss. I'm very sure that this problem can be solved. It's not a problem that is insurmountable. But you know, the adjournment of the House was also predetermined, because Senate adjourned to 21st. The same thing, House of Reps adjourned to 21st.
So the agenda was outside the House?
It was taken outside the House before the sitting on that day. If it was not
so
taken...
So, APC, you should know, you tell us,
I was not aware. If it was not taken, how did it come to... the coincidence? You understand me? And what happened in the House does not mean that we have to adjourn the House for that long period
for
of
one
time.
Month.
At least it was settled and the House sat. Later,
but
to adjourn.
Don't forget
you understand?
Work is still ongoing.
I want to ask Honorable Shuaibu a question. I've been listening to you, and it looks like you're suggesting that there's an unseen hand, piloting the affairs of the House and probably the Senate, that is an unseen hand. Like what you said about the adjournment, some of the things that are happening. Are you uncomfortable with that kind of arrangement?
Of course, I should be uncomfortable. We should have been operating independently. These two houses are independent houses.
Who's your seen hand?
We should be operating. We don't know. But how did they decide that we should?
EJ, is it the PDP that's your seen hand?
We should all adjourn to 21st.
Those who cannot.
Why did
people who
after and you see the Senate? There was that. What happened in the House of Reps did not happen in the Senate.
So why did they?
Why did they have to also adjourn to 21st?
Honorable Shaibu. Honorable Shaibu. I think the PDP is not on trial. APC.
EJ, answer this question. Is the PDP the unseen hand in this problem in the APC?
When you're talking about unseen hand, what do you mean unseen hand? First of all, PDP supported Saraki. PDP supported. Dogara. So we want Nigeria to move forward. What APC should do? They should accept that Speaker of the House is Dogara and the Senate President Saraki. They should be able to accept it. Nigeria can move forward. If they have accepted, let them sit down, reason together, so that they can have, equal right. Politics is about sharing, give and take. It's not about winner takes all. Until they are able to sit there in their home.
But PDP took all for 16 years. PDP took all for 16 years. So why wouldn't they let...
Do you know what is happening now? People are now crying. Nigerians are now saying, we thought PDP, they were the problem. PDP really are not the problem. They are regretting that they voted Jonathan out because of what is happening now.
Nigerians are regretting.
The thing is that when you see this type of problem happening, it's cumulative.
I think it's too early to draw that
conclusion.
It's too early to draw that conclusion. Just after 1 month. Because when you begin to be an ingrate, let's see, I'm not only bringing for Tinubu. Tinubu, Amaechi, look at them. And Saraki, they brought into APC. That's how APC became formidable. I was part of PDP. I've been part of PDP. and happened to be secretary of the screening committee. When they walked out, new PDP walked out of Eagle Square, which he belonged to. He was a member of PDP. They were among those who walked out on President Jonathan at Eagle Square and ran to go and join APC. Now, they thought going to join APC would solve their problem. They are now facing a different issue that, look, it is not that easy. I tell you,
they are not complaining.
We are not complaining.
We are doing the right thing. What we are telling you is that as we supported you for 16 years, we supported PDP. You should also, PDP also, support APC. Let's see what we can do. You promised transformation in your own. Let me tell you.
How did you support PDP?
I'm coming. You promised.
No, tell me, how
I'm
did coming. You support
I'm
PDP?
I'm coming.
Honorable Shaib is trying to make a point.
No, it's like you are biased here.
You promised transformation.
Let's take this out of APC, right?
No. In your constituency.
No.
In my constituency. They all mean virtually. Transformation, you are going to transform them into a better life and better things. Change, you have to change their life to better life and better things. Yeah. So let's work together so that we can get both the transformation and the change in our values.
First of all, you go and work together with yourself. One, you know why you are getting it wrong?
What?
Those who gave you ladder to climb. You get there, you throw away the ladder. That's the problem you are facing.
Who gave us the ladder?
Look. Do you know? He said two good heads are better than one.
No, who gave us the ladder?
It's a collective effort. Tinubu, Saraki, name all of them. They gave you so much support that made you to be formidable today. Look at Tinubu now. You are saying that Tinubu is nowhere.
Who said this one is nowhere?
Settle your differences. No. We PDP,
who said we
are watching
you. Did you hear it from the president? Did he say that Tinubu is not
important? President is not part of.
Okay, gentlemen. Let's redirect. Honorable, let's redirect. You know, I had asked what's the way forward, but I'm going to come directly to you, Honorable Shuaibu. Nigerians expected and still expecting a lot from the APC. Are you satisfied the way APC has carried on in the last 1 month? Do you think that the APC so far has, you know,
demonstrated
the capacity to bring this change? I mean, talk to us sincerely.
Well, of course, yes. We have, APC has the capacity to bring the required change. APC, since day one, has demonstrated that. It's a very formidable political party, very formidable, and people elected, you see, what the Nigerian people elected us because we promised them change in APC. And how do you bring that change? If this fight has come, maybe if after forming government, after settling down and this, and people begin to fight, it will have been a major problem. But this thing came very early. So at least it can be able to be sorted out and we move forward. And I don't think all these things are even overblown. There is no much deal about it. As I said earlier on, adjourning the house to 21st, because of what happened that day, you don't require you to adjourn the house to 21st.
Honorable, the APC is already blaming PDP. Is it not possible that the PDP has opened its flanks? I mean, the APC has opened its flanks, made mistakes, giving the PDP an opportunity to leverage on your mistakes.
Definitely mistakes will be made, and adjustments have to be made, because we have gone through a long period of suffering. And you know what Nigerians are expecting? Nigerians are expecting immediate results. With the resources now, you cannot get that immediate result. But definitely, with time, at least, I think this your question should come maybe 3 months after today.
No, but let you do whatever you like, even if the country was drifting.
By that time, you see change. No, the country is not drifting. Who is saying the country is drifting? We're not drifting. Are we drifting? The president is working. Is he not working? All the governors are working. Are they not working? The governors are working in my state.
When Nigerians are watching us.
Definitely in my state, the governor has done a lot within the last few days that he has been in government. He has awarded a lot of road contracts. We have paid all our salaries and other things. So the government is working.
What has the federal government, APC federal government, what has it done in the last one month? Can you name one, two, three for us?
You can't even appoint ministers.
Appointment of ministers. Even the last administration did not appoint ministers.
No. What has APC done in the last 1 month? Can you tabulate it for us?
He has been able to visit so many of our partners to get support for us, for Nigeria. He has been able to restore the confidence of the international community on the Nigerian country. That confidence has been restored. You will see the number.
It was not there before?
It was not there. People have lost confidence in Nigeria.
Who?
Our foreign partners.
How?
Even America.
How?
People, the support now, especially in the Northeast, fighting insurgency.
How?
In the Northeast. America refused.
But there are more insurgent attacks in the last two months of Jonathan.
My constituency was completely taken
over. They said they were going to stop it as soon as they come in.
My constituency was completely taken over. How many local governments are
but
under?
Jonathan, the tide changed while Jonathan was still president.
How many local governments are under insurgency today? And how many were there before the...
It changed while Jonathan was still president. What has happened in the last 1 month?
Because immediately Buhari won election, things began to change.
Mr. Obiora, you know the problem here, we have what we call marriage of convenience, where you have people coming together for one common goal, for one common interest. That interest was to come together, regardless of what happened, let's get Jonathan out of the way. They all came together. Now they have gotten Jonathan out of the way, it's now to not share. The food is on the table. Everybody is now fighting. Who want to eat the food? Who want to take the center? Now they cannot come together. So drop 12 finger at PDP. PDP is not on trial. APC is the one on trial here. But I want to say one thing. Please, I understand that President just sworn in, a lot of expectation, even the same thing with National Assembly. Let me say that all of you that have been thinking about the allowances and all that, do you know that some member of National Assembly members today have they can't even afford to pay for where they can stay. A lot is going on. We are talking about funding. I want to bring this because you have been questioning me about this, that National Assembly members, some of them cannot even have a place to stay.
Why?
Because when you are paying for a hotel, it costs money. Okay? Some of them take taxis to come to the house.
And then Nigerians take taxes. What's wonderful? What's so different about a member taking taxes?
It's beautiful, but you, media, I'm part of media. The way you have portrayed the National Assembly,
I take taxes to come to work sometimes.
Okay, but the way you
are they not Nigerians?
That the allowances that they are paying us to paint us black, we are just coming in.
Not that they are going to pay.
What he's saying is that the treasury is empty, so no allowance has been paid, nothing has been paid.
But is that correct?
That's what he's saying.
I mean, PDP emptied the treasury before the left.
Buhari decided to remobilize the treasury.
You can also hear that PDP left over $30 billion. The Foreign Reserve Account. Did you hear that?
Yes.
PDP. We are worse stronger, but on a very serious note, let's put Nigerians first. Let's come to do what is right. Whether PDP or no PDP or APC, it is not the name PDP or APC. You were a former PDP member who are now APC. You are not criticizing PDP of the past, which, of course, you were a member.
Shuaibu, do you think anything good will come out of the meetings that the APC will hold in the next few days?
No, definitely, APC is whether it is marriage of convenience or whatever marriage you call it.
To put it together somehow.
It definitely have to come together. If we put Nigeria as our priority, we put Nigeria that we are all working for the interests of Nigeria, definitely we'll agree and we'll move forward. So
okay.
I don't think we have that problem.
I still have faith in him. He will work.
We have been moving forward.
And I just believe that we just need to pray for this country. And I still believe he will do, at least move Nigeria to
my
the
front. But PDP
is still very formidable.
That was your message. Well,
thank you
so much. Your first time on the show, and so you get to take that home.
Thank you.
EJ,
I'm calling my lawyers because you accuse me of bias. I'm calling my lawyers.
Yeah, you call your lawyer. I have no problem.
No, we are all in APC.
We are all in APC. All right, gentlemen. Thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
All right.
Thank you, gentlemen. always interesting having these members
of the National Assembly. It's going to be definitely a very wonderful house with robust debates.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, they started on a very stormy note, but I'm sure once they get this issue of leadership behind them, Nigerians will get to see that this 8th National Assembly will be a better one.
I think so too. I think so because we have very... we have quality members, a lot of professors, a lot of professionals.
Yes.
Anyway, we'll be here again on Tuesday night at 11 p.m. I am Obiora Ilo from Abuja, Nigeria.
And I am Mamode Akua. Thank you all so much for watching. See you Tuesday night. Bye for now.
Me want your back deep on the ground, you know. From the way you are looking, man, I sound like yating. Y'all pick me, don't keep me waiting. Straight for no time for dating. How you look so motivating, yeah. Inspire me in every morning. You make my body calling, yeah. Girl bikini, you are yummy yummy. I feel the girl will make me feel fine. Every day she make me feel fine. This is how she make me feel fine. So she walk up on a slow wine. Sugar, sugar, the girl the more sugar. Honey, honey, the girl the more.
Okay, see, I am the girl them lover man.
Lover man.
Protect them like Spider-Man. They call me every weatherman.
Weatherman.
One day bed, I'm a winner man. Bedroom bully for the girl bikini. The clean love all the girl bikini. From Nigeria down to foreign. See the girl them buck up on it. See the girl them shocky on it. And she call me dancing.